was a wet rainy day when Fappy looked out of the window at the rain and thought about her parents. They were on a long holiday traveling round the world. They said that Poppy was too young to go, and so she was staying with her aunt, Aunt Bella, in her funny old house with lots of rooms and strange noises. Poppy felt bored, as she was all alone in the big house. Aunt Bella had gone out to visit one of her friends. It was now raining hard, so Poppy could not even go out. She went upstairs and stood in front of a locked room. She looked around. A rusted key lay on a small table in the corner. The lock was rusted too. She decided to open the room and go in. A heartbeat turned fast as she turned the key. It was difficult, but it moved. She heard a click, and the door opened as if magic. Poppy stepped into the strangest room she had ever seen. The walls were decorated with sparkly silver and gold stars and moons, but were changing colors very fast. The furniture was strange too. On the left was a sofa, but it wasn't on the floor. It was hanging in the air and moved round on the ceiling. Poppy sat on one of the chairs lying on the floor in the center of the room. Immediately, the table in front got covered with delicious food, cakes, pizzas, cold drinks, and ice creams. Poppy took a cake and tasted it. Mmm, heavenly! A taste out of this world. As Poppy sat enjoying the food, the walls that were changing colors became dark. The room was filled with a light, mysterious darkness. She switched on the gold lamp next to the table. As she did so, she heard a sound, whoosh, and the room was filled with smoke. For a while, she couldn't see anything. As the smoke settled down, she saw a figure appear, and then she saw it was a boy. "Hi," said the boy. "I am the genie of the lamp. Who are you?" "I am Poppy," she replied, "but you don't look like a genie." The boy was wearing expensive clothes and looked like any ordinary boy. "How would I come to know that you are a real genie?" said Poppy. The boy looked at her and muttered a kind of spell. Hip hop, hip hop. And suddenly, Poppy was in the air on the ceiling. "Okay, I believe you," she shouted. "Get me down." Poppy floated down to the floor and landed softly. The boy asked Poppy if she had a wish that he could fulfill. Poppy replied that she did not have any wish. She paused and said, "I can't tell how lonely I am, and I just don't have any friends." The genie listened patiently and stood up and said, "Well, bye. I must go now." The smoky cloud appeared again, and suddenly he was gone. Then the front door banged and she heard Aunt Bella arriving. I've got a surprise for you, Poppy, she said. She gave Poppy a box. A strange noise was coming from inside. Poppy opened the box and found a cute little puppy. The puppy looked at her with big eyes and barked, "Hello!" Poppy smiled and felt happy. She went into the garden to play with her new puppy. The next day, Poppy decided to say thank you to the genie. But there was nothing upstairs.